prayer against satanic attack, accusation, and condemnation. They like to condemn you. They like to accuse you. They're always attacking you. By the power in the blood of Jesus, the present worship that we have done, let the God of Elijah destroy them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I welcome everyone in the name of Jesus Christ. Good morning, good afternoon. How are you? Welcome. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Welcome you. We are here in Brampton, Canada. We are worshiping God here. God is wholesome God. He's an omnipotent God. So we are coming to, I'm coming to you this morning, this afternoon, wherever time in your country, to give you good news, to stop the enemy who is attacking you all the time, accusing you, condemning you. They like to accuse you. You know, they accuse you from no reason. They just accuse you. Spiritual accusation, physical accusation. You know, people are being accused. You can be taken to the spiritual court and they accuse you and they jail you, they put you in prison. Therefore, I'm bringing good news to you. I am talking to you right now. Anybody who has been condemned, being attacked by Satan, being attacked physically, being attacked spiritually, I am bringing good news to you. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I command your accusers to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I command satanic oracle consulted against you to attack you. I command them to attack their honor in the name of Jesus. I command them to attack their honor. Satanic attack. This is the prayer that I prepared this morning. Satanic oracle consulted against you to attack you. Attack your honor in the name of Jesus. Every satanic oracle planning to attack you, let them attack their honor. Let them turn direction and go and attack their honor. Let them attack themselves in Jesus' name. Satanic accusation, I speak to you right now by the power and the blood of Jesus. You accuse this person, even you put them in prison physically. Yes, satanic oracle. It is the prayer that satanic oracle consulted against you to attack you. They go to consult their oracle to prepare attack. When they send arrows to you, some of you, they don't wake up. They can even die. They can be rushed to hospital. They get heart attack. They get sickness. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I destroy them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you. Jesus, break every yoke, break every yoke, break every yoke, every satanic yoke, every satanic accusation, every satanic condemnation, blood of Jesus, break them, break them, break them, break every yoke, break, 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 in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ. Isaiah 10 verse 27, it gives us power to command every yoke, every satanic yoke, every satanic accusation, every satanic condemnation to break into pieces in the mighty name of Jesus. Break by the power and the blood of Jesus. Break, break every yoke in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Rapa shatoro raba kuria ndara raba kuria yamba baba shitoro robo kuria mbaba baba shanta o raba papa shantere raba kuria. Yes, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, my God and my Father. In the name of Jesus, I release the power of Holy Ghost, to enter into your people. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, fill your people with joy. Fill your people with Holy Ghost. Fill your people, God, my Father. Fill your people, my God, with the levers of revelation. Fill your people with the understanding, God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As this prayer enter in their life, let them be filled in the name of Jesus, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Rapapa Shato. Yes. Hello? Yes, yes, sorry. I have started a prayer, but I prayed for you last night. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus, my God and my Father. I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to give you all the glory, God. I want to honor you, my God, my Father and my God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I want to thank you, my Father. I bless your name, Jesus. I give you all the glory, my Father and my God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless your name. I give you all the glory, Jesus. You are wonderful. You are worthy, King of glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Prayer against a satanic accusation. Prayer against satanic accusation and condemnation. Prayer against satanic attack, accusation, and condemnation. You must be acknowledgeable in response. When you are being accused, when you are being attacked, when you are being condemned by the devil, you must learn, you must be knowledgeable. You must know how to respond. You don't have to cry. I've said this. Don't give the enemy your tears. Many people, they like to give tears to the devil. The devil will break dance. If you give the devil tears, they will celebrate and dance. Because they say you don't know what you are doing. When you are being attacked, when you are being accused, when you are being condemned, the first thing you have to tell the devil that from the book of Romans 8 verse 1, tell the devil there is therefore no condemnation to them which are in Christ. Put a stop by the devil, because they like to condemn people. They like to accuse people. They like to attack people. Remind him, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. We walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. No blame, shame, guilt, or accusation. You take authority. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. You command the devil no shame, guilt, no accusation. I take possession of my freedom from all of you, from all my past sins and from the present sin. So you command the devil, I take possession of the past sin and from the present sin. So there is nothing, there is no way you can condemn me in the name of Jesus. Take your hand from me, devil. Take your position from my life. You, Satan, take your hand from my life in the name of Jesus. You command the devil to assure him that there is no condemnation. There is no accusation. You name yourself, you say, Christine Isigi. There is no condemnation. There is no guilt. There is no shame in the name of Jesus. You tell the devil, you risen devil, Satan, I am talking to you right now. You have been attacking me all the time. I have commanded you, anything you are using against me to attack me, I bury them. I destroy them. You must be confident with the God you have. You must be assured with the God you have that the enemy is attacking you. Where there is a cause, there is a curse. Therefore, you revise every cause. Anything that has given the enemy access to come and attack you, you repent straight away and you ask the devil, devil, God, Jehovah has forgiven me and you have no right to attack me. Therefore, everything you are planning against me, I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. You take me to the court of the law because you are lying. I am taking the authority by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let those lawyers, let those crown, let those judges be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. Satan. satanic courtroom, satanic churches, satanic crown, let them be furnished by the power and the blood of Jesus. Because there is no condemnation. The book of Romans 1, it has given you power to claim your right, to say that you don't walk on flesh. You are walking by the Spirit of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus Christ. God, I want to thank you so much. My God, I want to give you all the glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I bless your name. I thank you, Jesus. Look at what Joshua said. Joshua said, and the Lord give them rest around about according to that he sware unto their fathers. And there stood not a man of all the enemy before them. The Lord delivered all of them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. You know, our God has promised us. Look at what happened to Joshua. When the enemies were attacking Joshua, God gave Joshua the enemies to their hand. The Lord delivered all their enemies into their hands. When you tell the devil, it is written, devil, by the power and the blood of Jesus, there is no condemnation. There is no accusation. When they come to attack you, the Lord will bring them to your hand, and it will be on your step. You will trample on them. According to Luke 10, verse 19, where the Bible says, you will trample on serpent and scorpion. Nothing by all means hurt you in the name of Jesus. You will trample upon your accusation, upon your condemnation, upon satanic attack. Without fear, without regretting, you will trample on them. You will trample, you put them on your feet. You tell them, therefore you are on my feet. In the name of Jesus, I bring that accusation. In the name of Jesus, I bring that attack you are attacking. If it is finances, you command them by the power, by the authority of Jesus Christ, I destroy you. Get out of from my life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Confess like Joshua confessed. Joshua confessed like this. That God has delivered the enemy unto your hands. Joshua persistently, repeatedly, and say this confession that the God has delivered my enemy. So you say, I am delivered. Every accusation, every condemnation, God has delivered me. God has delivered me. I will never be condemned. No powers of darkness will condemn me. No attack of the devil will attack me. No accusation. There will be no accusation in the name of Jesus. Every accuser, your accuser, I be arrested. I will be delivered. I will be delivered. You just repeated saying like that. Then the enemy will be disgraced and exposed. There is no way that the Lord Almighty will not come to you. When you stand with the true word of God, when you tell the devil the truth, when you stand and without panicking, without, yes, you might face some stuff difficult. Don't panic. Go with the fire ant. The kingdom of God serve the fire ant, and the fire ant will take by force. Go with the fire ant like a mad wounded lion, like a mad prophet. You go there, you make the enemy to run crazy. When you don't have to fear, face the enemy. Tell the enemy, you come to attack me in the name of Jesus Christ. I am for you. I will fight you. You don't have to fear. Because some people, they get terrified. They get fear scared. They don't know what to do. Stand up. Command the devil. Tell the devil there is no condemnation. There is no accusation. There is no guilt and shame by the power and the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus, I thank you. Yes, you pray. Prayer machine gun prayer bullet. This is what I'm going to pray. You pray every evil agent, carry your message to your sender and release the arrows you brought to me against me in the name of Jesus. You command every evil agent that is coming to accuse you to call their own message back to the sender. If they come to condemn you, you command you agents of Satan, you are coming to condemn you. I command you to call your own message back to wherever we are sent you. You know the demons are sent by the devil. So once they are sent, like God sent the angels. So the devil has his own demons and their evil angels to use to people. Therefore, you command them, you agents of Satan, hear the word of God. I command you to send that message back to the owner. Every arrow you bring to me, I command you to go back to the owner in the name of Jesus. Release every arrow back to the owner in the name of Jesus Christ. You need to fire back. You don't have to sit down to cry. You have to fight. Like now, when you attack the devil, they will fight the deadly fight. But the blood of Jesus has destroyed them. Spiritual warfare prayer is to fight. You don't pray good prayers. I'm telling you, whether people like it or not, this is spiritual warfare. Everybody needs spiritual warfare. People are suffering. People are tormented. Many people are suffering in the church. And they are even dying, losing their house properties, and they have no alternative. And they are in the church. Why do you, in the church, you are being attacked so much? You are a church, big church. You pray every time, you fast, you give your tithes, but you have so much going on. Why? And Jesus Christ is here. What's wrong? What's wrong? I'm telling you what's wrong. What is going on with your life? Why do you live in such a place? And you are suffering like this. You need spiritual warfare. You have to attack the enemy so hard so that he can run a race to stop to attacking you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Yes, my Father. You are wonderful. Glorious God, I bless your name. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Yes, I know people, they don't like this prayer. They want to be deceived and lied. That's what they like. But if you tell them the truth, they don't want to follow the truth. Therefore, I am now standing to pray. You pray like this. This is prayer. This is Masinigan prayer period. Holy Ghost, break the backbone and destroy the roots of every evil that speaks against you. You pray that let the Holy Ghost break every backbone and destroy the roots of every evil that speaks against you. I was doing the prayer. Let me look at this prayer. It says, you pray like this, hallelujah, every killer diseases, I am not your candidate, die in the name of Jesus. You command every killer diseases. You know there's some sickness, killer disease that has been programmed into your life to take everything you have, all the money. Already, I was praying with a lady. She has spent almost $150,000. But still she's so sick. The doctor told her that she's going to die. When she called me, she said that she has done everything she can. Now the doctor has said she's going to die. She has flied to all the doctors in the world where they know that they can help her. $150,000. And this woman, she's thin. She's now waiting to die. I told her, you will not die. You will not die. You live. The doctors, they are not God. They are also dying. They are a human being like you. God has given you life. You need Jesus. So, preachers have been praying for her. Pastors have been praying for her. Prophets have been praying for her. Nothing. I'm telling you that these prayers, it works. Because you know how to attack the enemy. From the roots. From the roots you pray, Holy Ghost, break the backbones and destroy the roots of every evil that speaks against you, against your life. In the name of Jesus, I uproot them, every root speaking against you, speaking against your children, speaking against your life. I uproot them. Every sickness planted in your life, I uproot them in Jesus' name. Spirit husband that does not want you to marry, let them be uprooted from the roots. I cut them off in the name of Jesus. That is the satanic attack. They attack your marriage. They can attack your marriage so hard that you cannot be able to be married. That even when you are married, they can attack your marriage, split it. They condemn each other. They accuse each other. You find partners, they started accusing each other for no reason. The enemy has put some things on them. They have put the words in their mouth of the partners. The husband has his. The wife has hers also. Now they fight. Then they end up divorcing. It is not so. The Bible says, the plans of God is not so. There is no thunder over your marriage. satanic agent, come to destroy your marriage, come to destroy your children. I command them by the power and the blood of Jesus, be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. You use the keys of heavens to lock out problem from your life. You know we have been given keys. Remember yesterday's word about the keys of heaven that you have been given. The devil, the children of the devil, they know how to use these keys. They love people. Now you take the authority by the power and the blood of Jesus. You use the keys of heavens to lock out the problems from your life. Every problem you are facing, bring the keys of heaven and lock it. Bring the lock and the keys of heaven and lock it and put it in your pocket. In the name of Jesus, you pray like this. I use the keys of heaven to lock out problems from my life in Jesus' name. You pray like that. You pray, I use the keys. You say, I use the keys. I use the keys of heavens to lock out problems from my life and my children and my husband. Every problem that you are facing, you bring the keys of the lock of heaven and lock it. You bring the lock from heaven. Lock of heaven. Lock of heaven fall upon my hands. I lock every problem. When you lock the problem will not come out to come and accuse you, to come and torture you, to come and condemn you. You lock that problem immediately. When you go out, you lock your house because you know when you are locking, your house is safe. But if you leave open, anything can happen. Anything can enter in and destroy your stuff. But when a thief comes, he's the one to break. But 100% when you lock your house, there's no chances that a thief or other people or some people can come unless he come at night or unless he planned very well to come. But the keys, the lock of heaven is not so. It is sealed from heaven. So there's no thief, there's no criminal that will come to break it. When you put it in your pocket, you go with it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to bless your name. Thank you, Jesus. You pray like this. Oh, Lord, let your thunder and fire locate every covenant of witchcraft and wizard established against me from the total destruction in Jesus' name. When you raise up the thunder and the fire of God to locate every covenant of witchcraft, covenants where they meet, you send the fire. You send the fire and the thunder to thunder them. Believe me and know or not, many people are suffering, being attacked by witchcraft, and they are not aware what is going on. They are in the church. Do you know some churches, they call a lot of witchcraft? Do you know the church, some churches, they call a lot of wizards and evil people in the church? Not everyone you see in the church that they are born again. Many people in the church, they are not saved. So they come there to witch and do their activities in the church. Because the church, they are forgotten to have this fire. They have forgot to have this spiritual warfare prayers. So when you send the fire, you pray like, oh God, let thunder and the fire locate all covens of witches and wizards. Let the thunder and the fire of God locate every coven and witches and wizards established against you, against your business, against your life, against your work. Total destruction in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, destroy them. Release the thunder and the fire of God to locate them. You don't have to pray with the enemy. Enemy is an enemy. Enemy is an enemy that is coming to destroy you. The mission of the enemy is to destroy you and make you miserable, to fix you in a place that you cannot function. You have to be angry in the spirit. You don't have to pray. If you have been in the church and you are 40 years, 50 years, all 35 years, you try to get married, none. You get relationship. You are expecting with your whole heart that this will work. After 2 to 3 months, it goes, it ends up. You break up. It happened all the time. That you must sit down and see something is not right. I must do something about this. God himself has said it's not good for a man to live alone. Therefore, God has prepared you a partner to live with. I'm telling you, this deliverance prayers, it cost me a lot. I didn't know this. I was a minister. I have a church, my whole church. I was preaching like any other pastors. I never thought about this deliverance. There is deliverance, spiritual warfare, deliverance, there's salvation and healing. They are totally different. I used to know salvation and healing. And we know that Jesus delivered us all, so we don't need deliverance. We are delivered. That's a lie. You cannot, if you have been delivered, yes, why have you been in that situation? What is going on with your life? Why do you, you are in the church, you are following God years and years, but your situation is the same. Jesus delivered us when you take action of faith to send fire to the camp of the enemy, to send fire to the camp of witchcraft, to send fire to ancestral powers that is attacking you. Generational curses, Jesus died to you to break generational curses. You don't have to carry every partners of your family. You break the generational curses. Any church, they don't know how to break those churches, those generational curses. It will not go well with the members. Yes, thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to thank you. Jesus, I want to give you all the glory, my God. My Father and my God, I want to thank you, Jesus. I pray that every satanic investigation into your life, into your future, I command them to be dismantled in the name of Jesus. Satanic accuse, satanic attack, every satanic investigation, they are powers of the devil. Their work is investigate you. They do investigation and you are for your future, how you are going to get married, how you are going to do your business, how you have started the ministry, how it's going. Do you know the enemy? They've been chanting and speaking and cursing our ministry so much. They go pray and fasting. They want to destroy the ministry. But in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that let them be dismantled and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that every satanic investigation into your future, I command them to be dismantled in the name of Jesus. Let them be dismantled completely and never rest again in Jesus' name. My God, I thank you. Yes, Lord, I praise your name, God. I thank you, my God and my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I bring the blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, dismantle and destroy every satanic investigation, every satanic accusing, in the name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, my God. I dismantle every works of the devil, every activities of the enemy, by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, revive hidden things that will move you forward. Let God reveal you hidden things to move you forward. Let God reveal to you things to move you forward. Let God give you good friends to move you forward. Not unfriendly friend, not satanic friends. You know the enemy programmed evil people, evil friends. Evil people, they are the ones following you. Satanic people, that is the works of the devil programming you. Wherever you go, even boyfriend, the devil can, even girlfriends and boyfriend, people you are, who is going to marry you, the enemy, they program evil. Only evil, useless people, they are the ones who come into you. People who are useless, the enemy programmed them to come and kill you. As somebody that's been entrusted with you, I'm a useless person, even you don't want to look at it. That's what the enemy do. A university clutches, being followed by a grade 7 person, that cannot work. It can never work. A useless person. That's the enemy saying that you will never get anybody to love you. All the people you get, they are useless, who cannot help you. I pray that, oh God, reveal hidden things, reveal hidden people, reveal hidden treasures that will move you forward in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty will bring somebody in your life who will move you forward, will introduce you somebody who is more than you, whom you can bless and can bless you. That person, God can bring to you in Jesus' name. I pray that God can bring you the man you love. That God can bring you the girl you love, the woman you love on your heart. That you will be celebrating God and thank God together. A man who born, or a man who is born again, a man who loves you, a woman who is born again who loves you, not a child of the devil. And then you cheat yourself, you write that I will pray for them, the person to be saved so that we can marry. Don't do that. You will remind Jezebel, you will remind Lucifer, you will remind the enemy that will come in your house and destroy you completely, you will never recover. I pray that God Almighty will deliver you and reveal to you hidden things that you need to know. Let your eyes open in the name of Jesus Christ. My God, I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. Oh, Lord, my Father, we love you, Jesus. We need you, Lord, my Father, to feel the secret that we need to know in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. By the power that pulled down the wall of Jericho, let every problem in your life to die. By the power that moved Jericho, by the power that pulled down Jericho wall, let the problem that you are facing today to die. Let them die in Jesus' name. If that problem will die, it will never rise again in Jesus' name. Let me tell you that there's a problem, you need them to die. They have been following you for long. It is your high time to cry to God and tell God, let this problem to die. There was power in the Jericho that make the wall of Jericho to fall down. That power must appear to your situation and let that wall standing against you to fall down and be destroyed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you for joining. Lord, I bless your name. I thank you, God. You are wonderful. You are worthy, God, King of glory. I bless your name. I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, my God and my Father, I want to thank you, Lord. I bless your name. I give you all the glory, Jesus. My God, you are wonderful. You are what, God? I commit your people into your hand. Anybody cursing these people, wherever planning evil against the people, I pray let the blood of Jesus destroy them. Any evil speaking against you, let the blood of Jesus destroy them. Let the blood of Jesus attack them and bring them down in Jesus' name. Everyone that is going through some difficult, some hard time right now, I bleed the blood of Jesus over your life in the name of Jesus. I prophesy this morning that your life will move forward. Anyone that is standing against you shall go down and you will go up in the name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus. I know you've been crying a lot. I know when you are alone, you have been talking a lot by yourself a lot. You've been saying, what can I do? What must I do now? I've been praying, I've been doing this. You need spiritual warfare prayer. I've started deliverance training school. Join the class. Learn how to attack the enemy. Learn how to make prayer points, prayer bullet. I have 6 weeks training. Join the training. I have pastors from other churches. People are joining. I have 5 PhD holders in my class. I have ministers. If you want to become a minister, if you don't know how to go about it, call me. If you need training, I will train you. I have told you that this teaching is a university material, but I give you in a basic way. I give you certificate, I will attend you. If you don't know your calling, you don't know your gift, call me. I will help you to identify your gift. Some people, you have a gift, but you don't know. And your church cannot give you a chance to do the gift. Let me tell you that when you come to this class, you have opportunity to go overseas to preach there. You will be preaching in various churches. I will prepare you and set you to the call. Because you remember, the Bible says the harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. If you will become a laborer of God, God will use you. You have a gift, you have a special gift, but you don't know. Call me, I will help you. The training is 6 weeks. People have gone through the training. You will see them. I will bring them periscope, and they will start talking to you. They will tell you, I have doctors, PhD holders. They will come. You will hear them, and you see them. I'm telling you, they've learned something they've never discovered. You can have PhD, you can have degrees, you can be engineer, but in the work of God, things of God, you are zero. You don't know anything. I'm telling you, join this class. 6 weeks training, deliverance training. Prophetic and prophets, I will teach you. You know, the Bible says that many people are perished because of lack of knowledge. So if you don't learn, you don't want to get knowledge, you will be destroyed. You will remain in the box years and years. You don't move forward. Call me. Our number is 905-487-7196. Call me. I will help you. Our website is www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. Then we have a free line. You can call us or cell phone number. We have cell phone number. You can text us. Our number is 647-608-5207. That's the number you can reach us. If you don't have long distance, text us. You can WhatsApp or you can send email. overcomersdhm@gmail.com. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. Tomorrow I'm on 8 o'clock. God bless you. God bless you. Go to our website. There's a lot of materials there. Prayers are there. And look at the requirement of 6 weeks deliverance training school. It will help you. It will change your life. You will never be the same again. Many people are calling me from all over the world about this training. Pastors, they are calling me, and they didn't know. I tell them this is prayer that is going to help you. The package of 6 weeks, you will never be the same again. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. See you tomorrow, 8 o'clock. Bye-bye. Love you. There's nothing I can do about it. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.